Get ready to That's the Stars. Edward Astley, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Reivers.
Dear friend, join me over here in greeting our six gifted and celebrated people. Hello, celebrated people.
Hello, Rocco.
Hello, my darling.
How do you feel?
Wonderful. It's almost 8 weeks.
Isn't that?
Seven? It's seven. It's seven that I haven't smoked.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Bravo, bravo.
This fella has a new show beginning on CBS this fall, right?
Right.
It's going to be called The Ed Asner Show, right?
No. We have not determined that yet.
Oh, you haven't?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm not a flasher.
I'm going to call it The Ed Asner Show. Let's say hello to George Frederick and Kay Henry.
Now, here's old George. He's won a total of $15,600.
And he's being challenged by Kay Henry. They've had their first round questions, each of them. And at the moment, he's leading 3-1. And we'll begin this day's session with round two right after this. All right, here we go. Round two. Kay, you may have A or B.
B.
You want B. Okay. You didn't... Yes, you matched one person. Miss Mobley there. Yes. Marvin said... I just married a school teacher. And you know what? On our honeymoon, she gave me a blank. Good question. I love this one.
Yes, it is.
Marvin said, I just married a school teacher, and you know what? On our honeymoon, she gave me a blank. There's so many good choices to this one.
I know it. You just don't know, honey.
I wouldn't know what to say.
You just don't know where to start when you come right down to it.
All right. Okay. Kay Henry?
Very good, Ed. Excellent.
Marvin said, I just married a school teacher, and you know what? On our honeymoon, she gave me a blank.
Book?
A book? Okay, this is your second chance. And your last.
On our honeymoon, she gave me a book.
Book, she said. It's a little, I don't know. What do you say, Ed?
Well, that doesn't make her distinctive as a school teacher.
No, what would make her distinctive?
As a school teacher, I would think that she would have given Marvin a grade.
A grade, yeah. Anywhere from failing to A plus. What do you say?
You get an A plus, honey.
Thank you.
I said lesson in love.
A lesson in love.
A romantic answer.
Yes. She's looking for a book here. Charles?
This woman is very sick.
No.
I said test.
A test. Okay, Henry, you got to match the two remaining celebrities to stay in the game, and we go to Richard.
Gave him an A.
Gave him an A, so that means George wins the game.
Yeah.
Come on down, George. Hello there. You know, you confused me for a second there. That was very sportsmanlike of you to applaud his win. And when you started applauding, I said, what happened there? I knew you hadn't matched Richard. But anyway, Kay, I'm glad you came back here. And remember, Match Game 77 will have some gifts coming your way. So now you got a 47-year supply of pantyhose. Goodbye, Kay Henry. Hello, George.
Good morning.
Good morning, he says. You ready to have a go at it? Okay. We polled a recent studio audience. George got their best response to this. Blank blanket. Blank blanket. Now, the answer, remember, they gave most often will get you $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. Then the third one gets you $100.
George, this is your 10th game. Let's see what kind of help you're going to get from your friends over here.
I think I'll pick the same three. Richard?
An electric blanket.
Okay.
Charles?
The name of my new series.
What is that, Charles?
Wet blanket.
Wet blanket.
And Brett?
Brett?
What Charles always is at a party, a pig in a blanket.
A pig in a blanket. Pig in a blanket, wet blanket, and electric blanket. You may have one of those or give us one of your own.
I think wet blanket.
You want wet blanket? Who gave you that answer? Charles gave you that answer, wet blanket. You don't like that, audience?
No.
What would you say? You'd say electric blanket. You'd have electric blanket. Oh, I got a whole bunch of people here from overseas, from England here. You do have electric blankets. Oh, that's right. They have many electric blankets there because they have no central heating. I freeze myself over there. Now let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Well, you got it right off the bat. Congratulations, George. They may be right. Let's see what we got in the $250 number. Baby blanket.
Oh, I like that.
You know, this audience may be right after all here. What are they saying? Electric blanket, right? Okay, Harold, slide it. They were right. They're smarter than you are. Well, he's got the $15,000. Now, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $1,000, and we'll give it to you if you match one celebrity.
Richard again?
Okay, Richard.
Why didn't you take electric blanket then, George?
Yes, he gave you, George.
What? You what? Lose faith, don't you?
Oh, ye of little faith.
Just a second.
Oh, God!
Against Eugene, I didn't mean it.
Got him right in the arm there. Okay, here we go. Ready? Worth $1,000. Bread blank. That's B-R-E-A-D blank. Bread blank. Bread. He's finished.
That's it.
Okay, think about it. Give us an answer which you think will match his. Bread blank.
Bread box.
Bread box. Okay, turn around and face Richard there and ask him what he's got on that card.
Richard, what do you have on the card?
I don't have bread box, I'll tell you that.
You don't have bread box on the card.
Bread and butter.
Bread and butter. Bread and butter's a good one. Bread box, not bad. Bread butter, a little better. Okay, now, George, you picked up another, how much? Another $200 there. You're up to $15,800 or whatever it is. And we'll meet another opponent in a moment or so, but first this. Hello there. Hello there. Let's say hello to Beth Lawner. Hello, Beth. How are you?
Okay.
What's that say, Emma?
It's my father's initials.
All right. Beth, where are you from?
I'm from Brooklyn, New York.
Good girl. You live here now?
No, I'm visiting, and I hope to move out here. I would like to. I like the sunshine.
I
Much
see.
Much better than 10 degrees and gusts of 35 miles an hour.
Do you work there, or are you planning to work here?
I work there, and I'm an employment counselor, and I hope to get a job here.
Okay, good luck in that venture, and
Thank
good
you.
Luck in this venture, Beth. I'll ask you to make a selection. You may have A or B.
I think I'll try B.
B.
For Beth.
All right, B for Beth, she says. Here we go. When Fat Frida went to cannibal country, the cannibal chef took one look at her, and then he said, blank.
But I didn't hear. You know, it's one of those things.
When Fat Frida went to cannibal country,
yes.
The cannibal chef took one look at her, and then he said, blank.
Fat Frida.
You remember Fat Frida?
Oh, very well. Who could forget it?
Oh, I got it.
You got it. First round questions, remember, are a little more difficult. You got it. Okay, Ed. All right. Have you thought about it, Beth? I'll give it to you one more time.
Okay.
When Fat Frida went to cannibal country, the cannibal chef took one look at her
And then he said,
wow.
Wow?
Lots of dinner.
Spelled backwards.
Yeah, spelled backwards.
Wow.
Wow. Okay, what do you said?
Well, I think he was all, is that expressive, but it was a little more applicable to
more,
food.
Yes.
So the cannibal chief said, yummy!
Yummy! You kind of meant that, Beth, but
I
you
did.
Should have been a little more specific there. Okay, what do you say?
Wummy, we would have accepted.
Yeah, wummy, wummy, he would have been good.
Yes, I said, stuff her, and we'll have her for Christmas.
Yeah. What do you say, Charles?
He said, dinner is served.
Dinner is served. Well, you're all on the right track, and Beth is looking for this word, wow. How about you?
So am I.
Oh, really?
But I said,
Ain't that something?
Well, Mazda, isn't it?
Yes.
He took one look and he said, dinner for everyone.
Chow call. How about you, Patty?
And then he said, talk about your leftovers.
Talk about your leftovers. There were plenty. Okay. Our friends from overseas, I think, are finally beginning to get the hang of this, aren't you, there? Okay, ready for this one now. Here we go. When 98-year-old Mrs. Periwinkle came back from the doctor, she said, Mr. Periwinkle? Guess what, Mr. Periwinkle? I'm pregnant. And he said,
guess what? I'm blank.
If you think it's that funny, write it down.
She, Mr.
When 98-year-old Mrs. Periwinkle came back from the doctor, she said to Mr. Periwinkle, guess what, I'm pregnant. And he said, guess what, I'm blank. Write it down on the card there and everything
will
be all right.
Yes, I certainly will.
Okay. All right.
Wait a minute.
Oh, wait a minute. You mean you haven't started to write yet, Charles?
I'm finished, practically.
Oh, there's a marvelous answer to this, Charles.
There are several.
One terrific one.
Yes, yes, I think you're right.
And absolutely hilariously amusing, if it comes into your...
I have a better one.
Well, take it out. Put it on quickly now. All right, let's go. We're going to start without you, Charles.
He isn't even...
All ready, okay. You ready, George?
Oh, thank you.
When 98-year-old Mrs. Periwinkle came back from the doctor, she said to Mr. Periwinkle, guess what, I'm pregnant. He said, guess what, I'm blank.
Can't say. Guess what? I'm impotent.
Okay. He said, guess what? I'm impotent.
Well,
what do you say to that?
Mrs. Periwinkle said what?
Mrs. Perry said, guess what? I'm pregnant.
And Mr. Periwinkle said,
I'm not surprised.
I'm not surprised.
I say that self-deluded.
Mr. Perry said, I'm curious as to who the father might be. How?
I like that, too. That's two winners so far, Charles.
I said death.
I'm deaf.
Guess what? I'm pregnant. Guess what? I'm deaf.
On the second reading, it's not so bad, is it, there? All right, we have three pretty good ones so far. Marianne, now we come to you. Don't let us down.
Oh, I wouldn't for the world.
What do you say to that?
I think we've got a match. I mean,
really?
I thought,
yes.
And it didn't help a bit. And I did because I'm sterile.
That's one for George. What? Yes, you're not.
No.
No? No, for a second there, we heard a bell. Now, wait a minute. To those of you who have not graduated from medical school as I am,
or grammar
impotency
school.
And sterility are not the same things.
But
and
they, it's the
I'm
same result.
Yeah, but I'm not. No, but in different ways, so... And we can't go in the picture, no diagrams or anything like that. Yes.
That's why I went with deaf. It seems so simple.
All right. Mr. Periwinkle, she said to Mr. Periwinkle,
guess what? I'm pregnant.
And he said, guess what? I'm not.
Not such a big build-up.
Okay.
No, because being old and senile, he said it twice.
He said it twice. Guess what? I'm not. Okay, so there we are at the end of round one. We have no score. Round two coming up after this. Hello.
Oh, yes. I'm like that.
Yes. I'm just having a little colloquy with someone in the audience. And we will continue later, but right now we have to go on with round number two here and ask Beth to make a selection.
I'm going
to
stick with B.
B for Beth. Everybody,
please. Who makes up all the lines?
What?
Who makes up all the lines?
Who makes up all these lines? These lines, you mean?
Yeah.
Yes.
That was the question the lady asked.
Oh, that was the question
the lady asked. Who are you going to
explain? Well, we have four writers. We've got Joel Hecht and Bobby Sherman and Dick DiBartolo and Joe Newstein. I say Newstein, but he prefers Newstein.
Did you fire Bill Shakespeare?
What's that? Well, Elliot Feldman, I forgot about him. We've got five weirdos, not four weirdos. No wonder.
And the only qualification, you must fail college.
That's right. Oh, yeah, no degreed people are allowed here. Now listen to this. The wagon master said...
What did he say?
He says, say, that really is a band of Indians. The leader isn't carrying a spear, he's carrying a blank. That really is a band of Indians. A band of
band.
Indians.
That's the operative word is band.
The leader isn't carrying a spear. He's carrying a blank.
Oh, I've got it. I've got it.
Here we go.
Okay. All right. Now, Beth. The wagon master said, say, that really is a band of Indians. The leader isn't carrying a spear, he's carrying a...
Guitar.
Guitar. All right. She said guitar. That's the instrument of young people these days. And she's a young person.
I'm an old-timer.
You're an old-timer? Yeah. What do old-timers say?
A flugelhorn.
A flugelhorn. Well, that looks like a spear. What do you say?
I say, I always think in terms of a leader. As soon as I said he was carrying a baton.
Baton. That's a good answer.
I thought that was the definitive answer.
That's a good answer, a baton, yes. Charles?
Baton.
Baton.
Baton
seems to be the answer. And now that I hear it, it makes a lot of sense. Doesn't it, Marianne?
It certainly does.
But you don't have it.
Wrong. Baton.
Oh, you do have it. There's a lot of batons there so far for you, my dear. Richard?
What? A baton.
A baton there. And Patty?
Baton.
Baton. Okay. Now, George, all you got to do is match one. You will have won your 11th game. Will that be more games than anyone else has ever won on this show? I guess 10 is more than anyone else has won. I don't remember going to 10. Here it is. There was a Miss America a few years ago.
One of those?
Who wasn't very talented. In fact, for the talent portion of the contest, all she did was walk up to Burt Parks and blank his teeth. Quickly now. Okay, Miss America. Some years ago, she wasn't very talented. All she did for the talent portion of the contest was walk up to Burt Parks
and finished.
Blank his teeth. Good for you. Okay.
You.
Here we go. All right, George. There was a Miss America a few years ago who was not very talented. In fact, for the talent portion of the contest, all she did was walk up to Burt Parks and blank his teeth.
Pick
his teeth. Beth, all is not lost. What do you say, Ed?
Well, once again, we're dealing with music and that Indian leader, and I said pick.
Pick wins again. Over there later. Right now, we got to say goodbye to Beth Lawner and thank you for being with us. Many
thank
gifts
you
for
much.
You. Beth Lawner, and while we're spinning her off, let's spin this commercial for you.
Join us next time for Match Game 77. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye. We'll be right back.